I mentioned how happy I am to be working with you again, Coach.
I think you have, and I feel that same way.
Mark James, Bob Lovell at Beach Grove. As you can see, Roncalli leading Northwest 31-22. Pioneers need a bucket.
Well, the Pioneers are going up against a 3-2 zone at the half court by Roncalli.
Stepped out of bounds on the drive to the bucket.
Team, but you got a, you know, 9-point lead against a team that hasn't really attacked the glass and hasn't shot it well. It's not a bad look. Do it a couple of times, it doesn't hurt you.
48-46, the Northwest win during the season. Offensive foul, wave it off.
Little 1-2-2, 3-2, little odd-numbered front, same type of thing.
Ball almost turned over. DeAndre Starks off the leap and leaner, gets it to full.
Well, your defense got you what you wanted. You had an opportunity for the steal, but how about DeAndre Starks just getting in, being opportunistic, and finishing a play around the rim?
Mislin with a basketball, right elbow, looks underneath, and a foul. His third personal. Can we call it woeful?
Oh, man, oh, man.
That free throw rolls around deep in the well and comes back out. 7 the advantage. Northwest with a basketball. They trail it. Stop and go by Sims. Starks, three-pointer. No. Rebound controlled to Roncalli. Ball loose on the floor and a travel.
Oh, you don't have to settle for that three. Takes him to, or this three.
That one off the heel of the iron. Starks fights for the rebound and gets it. Wants to go up with it, but it comes loose on the floor, and we have a foul. 19 foul on Roncalli, and DeAndre Starks misfires from the free throw line. Almost stolen away. Reeser in transition, throws it down low, shot put up a little short. Mm. The misfire by Heckman, Northwest with the rebound.
Well, she saw the defenders coming from behind, did not go up strongly and finish. It seems like almost every possession down, everything but.
Total of 2 points have been scored in this quarter. It's 31-24, it was 31-22 at the end of the third. Boyd Miller posted up on the box, wanted the basketball, had the shorter man Sims on
him. Oh, what a great pick.
And then a pick by Donnell Milton. Minton lays it up off the glass and in.
I'll tell you what, that was clean. That was great defensive effort. And the finish, by the way.
That's a foul.
Get a couple of steals, get some things going.
That one no good. Rebound controlled by Keith Oliver, who has been everywhere for Northwest tonight. Sims, stop and go, floats it up in the paint. A little short. Rebound controlled by Roncalli.
Everything but the basket. Did what he needed to, but still.
Lead is 6. Reeser with a basketball for the Rebels. Lots of contact, no call. He'll drive, kick at the corner. A shot in rhythm, got deep in the well, no. And he followed his shot in, threw up the rebound shot, couldn't get it to fall. Reeser, some trouble getting it in. They finally kick it into the corner to Colin Lynch. As we approach the 5-minute mark, looking down low, and a foul. 6'4 senior, free throw is good.
More often than not, they'll call that as a foul.
How about that? Roncalli, 2 of 2 from the free throw line. Has to be
two
the first time tonight.
Throws.
34-26 Rebels.
Now Roncalli back in their zone at the half court.
5 minutes to play. Minton on the drive, floats it up in traffic, gets it blocked. A lot of body, but no call.
Man, tough.
Sometimes at the high school level, officials aren't going to reward a guy that goes in out of control. They're just not going to do it.
And that was a good move.
Reeser from 12. No. Rebound. Stolen away. DeAndre Starks runs it ahead, throwing it up off the glass. No. Wants to cut it to 6 and does.
Nice looking shot.
Reeser, here comes the full court pressure by Northwest. 34-28, 4.5 to play. Lynch a little shove in the back and no call. Again, Northwest forcing the offense out high. A lot of body there, no call.
Wow.
What is and isn't a foul?
That is a foul.
And it's tough for the kids because you just be consistent.
No, you're exactly right. I mean, you have an opportunity to call a couple fouls and miss both.
Mislin. Oh, nice spin move, but threw it up too hard. And look who's fighting for the rebound. And now they've.
It's 6, so you got time, but it's zone again. And if you're Northwest, you got to be smart, probe, attack.
14-footer.
Good
rolls
move.
Around,
just
no.
Didn't go.
Fighting for the rebound again as Oliver can't come up with it, but Roncalli does.
Donnell Minton had it. I mean, he had a nice move, just didn't go for him. And now you're going to call that.
Right.
But neither team shot it well at the line, so.
Colin Lynch missed
that opportunity. I'm not so sure any foul. I mean, right now, all fouls may be good fouls because no one's knocking down free throws.
Walker's third personal, by the way.
Great pass.
Get it in the paint. Ball knocked away. Last touch by Northwest. Much credit to Mosey Barnes. Boy, he has been quite reserved on the sideline.
Yeah, he has.
When he had every right not to be at times. It's close to the midcourt stripe there, an over and back violation, but Lynch gathers it back in, drives to the bucket, gets rid of it. Nice look down low, and the shot up and in by Patrick Heckman, who has 8 points.
Yeah, Kyle Lynch made a great move to the hoop. Great delivery, and Heckman with a good finish. That just comes off good penetration. No one slid over from Northwest to stop ball penetration.
Northwest does not need to push the panic button yet. Quick shot. And the rebound to Roncalli, and now the Rebels can be patient with 2.5 to play, and they're up 36-28. Lynch goes to Reeser.
Well, I think you'll see him really kind of spread it out, obviously, take care of it.
Reeser's first point of the night. Northwest has not really been able to string several buckets in from the free throw line, and suddenly the lead is 10 for the Rebels. Deep three, DeAndre Starks, no. Rebound controlled by Roncalli.
Wow.
Might have been a little quick for that, Coach.
Wow. But literally has dominated the second half.
He hits both free throws.
The Pioneers have had no answers.
Bet that helps admission.
You know, and it does. I mean, I was there yesterday, and there's just an electricity about it. I mean, three local teams. We forget, quite frankly, that oftentimes in years past, there have been a number of Indianapolis area teams that have participated in the same thing. But it is rather unique without question.
Well, no difference to the rest of the state, but when we have Central Indiana schools like Chittard, Roncalli, Cathedral, Warren Central, Carmel at the Lucas Oil Stadium for the football state finals, it pumps it up a little.
There's no question. But I think, you know, the Allen County War Memorial Coliseum, Mark, is a fantastic venue, and it's going to be a great day of basketball.
Boy, look at Roncalli. So patient
basketball. Clearly Roncalli came out with a little different look, a little different approach than that first time.
Mifflin with the basketball. Again, Roncalli playing keep away. Northwest choosing not to foul just yet, although that's a lot of contact for no call. Ball
well,
right
you got
away,
a lot of
court stripe.
A lot of people right there.
Sims throws
there
it up, gets
go.
It to fall and one. Trail by 10. Still trail by 10. 40-30. Mifflin.
Of not allowing Roncalli to get on the glass and hurt him. You're certainly disappointed if you're Mosey Barnes.
DeAndre Starks gets bumped. He'll go to the line for two. Starks with a free throw, no.
Well, and I think there's a certain level of truth to it.
Lynch with the basketball. Had the wide open layup, and they back it out instead.
Well, I think they've been told nothing but wide open layups.
Colin Lynch has but 2 points.
Of how they played in the second half.
Like that they'll visit with Brebeuf here Friday night at 6 o'clock. Nice drive to the bucket by DeAndre Starks. He has 12.
Yeah, and I think Starks understood. I mean, he could get to the glass because Roncalli not going to give him much resistance. It's March. The sun was shining.
No go on both free throws. Sims. Three-pointer, top of the circle. No. Rebound to Roncalli. 40 seconds left. 10-point lead for the Rebels. The difference in the ballgame.
No question.
30 seconds to play, 12-point lead. Deep three-pointer. No good. Rebound tapped out long, controlled by Northwest. Minton, Starks, buy some room. That three's no good. Rebound loose on the floor. Shot thrown up, a little short. Good battle underneath by Akeel Washington. He gets his first bucket. 10-point lead for Roncalli.
They're productive because
you have to bring it up the floor, just hold it. Well, the Roncalli Rebels improved to 14-6, and the season will end for Indianapolis Northwest.